we decided that enough is enough. The district level committees rejected about 80 to 85% of the claims. The High Court gave a very good landmark judgment in our case.
One acceptable evidence which would be acceptable to all is the evidence of satellite images. We could produce large number of maps in support of this, establishing that these people are cultivating. After this verification, it has found that in 99% of the claims was correct.
Tribals are the true sons of the soil. India has a tribal population of an estimated 100 million. Of them, 40 million, or say 8 to 10 million families, live in and around forests and other remote areas. In tribal areas or across forest lands, our tribal brethren have been cultivating their land passed on by their ancestors without any documentation in place. Not surprisingly, most of the tribals are treated as encroachers of their own land. These people in forest areas have suffered historic alienation because they were denied their traditional right to property and livelihood. The scheduled tribes and other traditional forest dwellers, Recognition of Forest Rights Act 2006 FRA, for the first time enabled local population in tribal villages to claim land rights, including community rights to village common resources such as water sources, minor forest produce, etc. According to the FRA, anybody cultivating his or her land or who has a hold on land as of December 2005 can claim title to the land. In Gujarat, NGO activism of a different kind has resulted in the FRA having scripted a completely different story. Amrish Mehta, a founding member of Action Research and Community Health and Development, ARC Bahini, an NGO working in the tribal areas of South and East Gujarat, says,
"Main stumbling block in proper implementation of this Forest Rights Act has been that lack of evidence. Because Forest Department says that only Forest Department documents are acceptable as evidence. Although Act says that other evidences are acceptable. For example, physical signs on the field, which can show that this field is being cultivated from long time, that is also acceptable. Past applications are also acceptable. Other evidences are also acceptable. But they were not willing to give proper weighted to all other evidences. They said we need a credible evidence."
At the dawn of 21st century, there was a nationwide campaign. ARC also joined that campaign, in which we decided that enough is enough. In most of the claim files, people had submitted all the acceptable evidences, even though the district level committee rejected this. And so we decided that now we have to go to the High Court. The High Court gave a very good landmark judgment in our case, and the High Court directed the state government to look into all the acceptable evidences and actually earmarked which evidences they have to look into. Now the tribals also should have stakes in the area they have been living for centuries, for generations. And so we decided that we should have some statute. There were statutes regarding the forest, but there were no statutes regarding tribals' rights. So in 2006, after much campaign and struggle, we got this act, this legislation, which is called Forest Rights Act. Forest Rights Act gives two types of rights. One is right on individual lands, which they have been cultivating before 2005. Another is rights on the forest resources of the area. So these two types of rights are there. Another thing is that the Gram Sabha is entrusted as an authority which will initiate the process of inviting the claims and then verifying the claims and then deciding their recommendation to the government authorities.
So one acceptable evidence which would be acceptable to all is the evidence of satellite images, which nobody can manipulate. Satellite has taken the pictures of this area, and satellites have been taking pictures of this area from 2000-2005. What we did was that we started carrying out GPS surveys of all the claim lands. So once the GPS surveys are carried out, we get the coordinates of the field of these farmers. Each farmer what field he's get cultivating, all these coordinates which are available, and we superimpose these plots of fields on satellite images from Google, from NRSA 2005, 2008, 2009, and we get a clear picture of what was the condition of this field in 2005, 2007, 2008. After this verification, it has found that in 99% of the claims, whatever Gram Sabha had recommended was correct. And as a result of this verification, now 97% of the claims.
Gram Sabhas got empowered.
My name is Kalya Bhai Remta Bhai. Remta Kocha thi aaj jameen khedta te ame. Pan tyare pehla jungle khata hairyan karta te ame. Pachi police khata hairyan karta te. SRP hairyan karta te. Pata dur jata rahiya.
Another aspect is how recognition of rights, both individual and community, is changing the behavior of the people. First thing which they would do is to invest in land leveling, land improvement, in sunk their own well or tube well, start irrigation. Now these people also have rights over forest produce like bamboo, timru, and other all minor forest produces now belong to Gram Sabha. And if you grow this bamboo in your own tree, on own fields, then also it belongs to you, or you can sell it. So many villages are engaged in that. And this has also the fact that now they have a property right over their fields and property right over their community, right over their forest resources. They have started taking steps to regenerate forests.